Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. This time I wanted to show you something very useful, a multi-platform package manager named stabilitymatrix. It got a lot of very useful features like managing all your models independently, so you can use it with different applications like automatic 1111, ComfyUI, SDNext, Invoke AI, or other less popular distributions, I guess. And it lets you manage the programming stuff a little bit easier if you don't want to mess with it or you got problems setting up multiple different web UIs, then this is a solution for you. First, just go to the homepage of Lycus AI and download the installer. Then go in and install it and wait for it to finish. After that, we can go in and take a step into the application so I can show you what I mean exactly by that. And when you are finished installing and you are booting up the application, you are greeted with this interface. On the left side, you got different tabs for different use cases. For example, the model browser, the checkpoints you got installed, different. Then the package manager, an inference tab, which I'm not going to explain for now. It's basically a variant to run stable diffusion web UIs without starting them up independently, and a launch tab. First, every model and checkpoint you install in the different packages, they are managed like they were available for other packages you install as well. For example, if you download specific models for ComfyUI, LoRAs or checkpoints, you also got them in Stable Diffusion Web UI, for example. So this is one also very useful applications. Another very useful thing is the programming part, I guess. You can manage it very easily. As you can see, you can update the different packages independently because they also are managed with different virtual environments in case of Python, so you don't have the problems with overwriting requirements or dependencies on your local installation of Python. So every package got its own Python installation behind it and is managed differently from each other. So you don't have the possibility to screw this up. Also, as you can see, you can add package and install the different web UIs with the dependent branches if you want. And when you install them, you can run them directly from here. But when you go into the launch tab, you can select them. And one of the very specific use cases I want to show you is the possibility to manage command arguments. For example, to start up web UI, you have different command line arguments. For example, VRAM settings, as you can see, you can simply choose them if you want to enable them. Stuff like X formers or API auto run settings, and so on and so on. You have managed very easily, as you can see, without going to search for specific arguments. And on the bottom you have also extra launch arguments if you want to choose. And if you don't know what to write, you can easily just add dash dash help and save. And when you start up the application, it's going to give you different arguments with an explanation and info what it's doing in the command. As you can see here, it's going to show you what's going to do, and if you're going to enable it, just copy the argument and paste it in here. And the different UIs have different command line arguments, and they are all already managed for you. So you can enable only those options which really matter or are specific for that web UI. So it's easily managed for every application. Just put in dash dash help and you can easily discern what you need to use and what you need to leave alone. Then save the settings and start up the application. You can also have different versions or branches of the same UI, so you can easily just experiment by yourself what works best, what's the best settings, and what's the most performance-wise choice for you. But that's basically it. If you want to have more information what's possible, I'm going to leave the GitHub repository and the link to the homepage in the video description, so you can easily go from there. Thank you very much for watching and see you next time.